for 6.5, so area again between the two curves. And this time, we're gonna start with the skill problems. We just say two functions are provided, and then you're gonna find the area between these two curves on the given intervals. If the graph is provided, that's nice. If not, you're gonna have to use a graphing tool to identify the area that you are going to find by setting up the definite integration. Okay, and then the application that we're gonna see later is about the business and economic situations is involving the consumer surplus and the producer surplus, the equilibrium point. Okay, we will get to that point eventually. So the first part is get started with the skill problems to get used to the definite integration that we use it to find the area between two curves. So for the first one, let me talk about the concept real quick. The two functions are provided, that the function f and the function g. The graph is continuous, like both of them. If one function is above the other, that means the function value of one is greater than the other function value over the interval, the AB. Then the area between two curves, see which one on the top one, the greater one first subtracted by the lower one. Okay, and when you set up the definite integration, the bound from point A to point B, lower limit A, upper limit B, the upper function. So some textbook, they use this term. They call this term as upper function and this function as the lower function. Like based on the graph, it's very clear which one upper, which one lower when you set it up. So when you find the area between two curves to set up the definite integration, what you have to do, first you're gonna simplify the integrand, collect like terms, simplify as much as we can, and then we use the antiderivative rule. Antiderivative, and then compute at the point A and point B and subtract them as the routine work that we have to find the definite integration value. All right, let's get started with this one. For this problem, we have the curve y equals x to the third and y equals x squared plus one. The graph is given, so we can see that the upper one is the parabola x squared plus one. So I call this as the upper function, and y equals x to the third is the lower function, because the function value of the top is very clear is higher than the function value of the bottom curve from the left bound to the right bound. So point A, negative one, point B, positive one. So when you set up the definite integration as the area, so the area equals the definite integral from lower limit to the upper limit, the upper function, so I'm gonna name it upper, subtracted by the lower, okay, with respect to x, equals the definite integral from negative one to one. The upper is x squared plus one, and then subtracted by the lower, which is x to the third power with respect to x. And then you take away the grouping symbol, you have x squared plus one minus x to the third. And this case, all three terms are not like terms, so nothing that you can simplify. The next step, what you would do, you just find the antiderivative. So we cannot simplify anything, right? So the next step, we're gonna find the antiderivative of each one of them. To find the antiderivative, see the first one, you see the power, we're gonna use the power rule. Second one, I'm gonna note it. This one, we're gonna use the power rule, the power r equals two. And for this one, the power r equals three. And the middle term is called the constant function. So I'm gonna put that note on the side, what rule I'm gonna apply. So integral of the x to the power r with respect to x, I'm gonna have to add the power to the r and then divide it by the new power there, right? And then since we have to do the lower limit, upper limit, so we do not have to add c. So we just have to evaluate at a and b at the end. This is the power one. I put a note, this is a power rule. And for the constant rule, so integral of the constant c with respect to x, the antiderivative is c times x. Okay, and then again, lower limit, upper limit. So we're gonna evaluate from a to b. So two rules will be used for this problem. Now we're gonna apply to each term. So the first term, since the power r is 2, so the antiderivative gonna be 2 plus 1, which is 3. And then the new power 3, we use as a denominator. The next one, the constant c equals 1. So gonna be 1 times x. Okay, 1 multiply, not 1 dot. Okay, 1 times x. And then subtracted by x to the third becomes x to the 3 plus 1, which is 4. And then all divided by 4. So now we have the antiderivative, the integral sign and the x, they go away. And then put the bar in the back. We're gonna remind ourselves, we will replace x with a negative 1 and x equals positive 1 as a lower limit and upper limit. Before we replace it, let's clean up to make it in the nicer form. So I will write it as 1 third times x to the third plus x minus 1 over 4 times x to the fourth. And then I will evaluate from negative 1 to positive 1. Okay, I'm going to use the notation A as an area just for our convenience. So A equals the area. So the A can be computed by the first row. You're going to put the upper limit 1, right? Going to put 1 first, 1 to the third plus quantity 1 minus 1 over 4, quantity 1 to the fourth. And then subtracted by the next group, you're going to replace x with the lower limit, which is negative 1. So 1 over 3, negative 1 to the third, plus negative 1 minus 1 over 4, negative 1 to the fourth power. So the sign is very sensitive, so be careful and do it, try not to do it very quick. So after we raise to the power and then simplify the number, I'm going to write what we have here. We have 1 over 3 plus 1 minus 1 over 4, and then the next group, negative 1 to the third power, that turns out to be negative 1 because negative 1 times itself 3 times. So in the parentheses, it's going to be negative 1 over 3 and then minus 1. And negative 1 to the fourth, that becomes positive 1. 1 times negative 1 over 4, that's negative 1 over 4. You see the sign not totally changed. It's going to be the term that has the negative power. Has the odd power, the sign switch to opposite 1. So now what we have, after we take away the grouping symbol, I can see that, let's do step by step, okay? So 1 over 3 plus 1 minus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 plus 1 over 4. And then I can take away the negative 1 over 4 and 1 over 4. I have 1 and 1, that combined to be 2. 1 third and 1 third becomes 2 over 3. So 2 over 3 plus 2, I will get going to be 2 over 3 plus 6 over 3, so going to be 8 over 3 as a result. As the area between these two graphs, or the yellow in the shaded area there.